for this video, Spear Dude will be exposing rumors about Olivia Rodrigo being a bad person. Spear Dude isn't a fan of Olivia Rodrigo because he thinks her music is generic. But he doesn't believe she's a bad person. And why doesn't he think she's a bad person? Because he's seen shit tons of real actual proof and evidence that she's not a bad person at all. And just because he's not a fan of Olivia Rodrigo, doesn't mean he can't defend her when he sees fake-ass allegations being made up about her. And here's the damn proof that Olivia Rodrigo is a very good person.
Olivia! 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 for learning.
Aww. Thank you guys. I feel so loved.
Yeah, the door. Have my hand in the door. I love you. I fucking love you.
This fan gave Olivia Rodrigo a keychain and couldn't believe what Olivia did with it. Olivia was in Paris last year and she met this fan on the street. The fan handed Olivia a very special gift and she was shocked. The fan gave Olivia a keychain of the Eiffel Tower because she was in Paris. Olivia smiled and covered her mouth because she couldn't believe the fan actually brought her a gift. Olivia didn't want to take the keychain at first, but the fan insisted he brought it just for her. Olivia eventually gave in and accepted the keychain. She hugged the fan goodbye. But the fan didn't know if Olivia would actually keep his keychain or not. But what Olivia actually did with the keychain will blow your mind. Olivia attached the keychain to her favorite purse, and she takes it with her everywhere she goes. Now, whenever fans post pictures with Olivia online, the fan from Paris sees his keychain on Olivia, and he knows she actually cares about him.
This is how Olivia Rodrigo handled a disrespectful statement from an interviewer.
A little chip in your tooth there also.
Oh, man.
You're not perfect after all. How did you get that?
I actually wasn't aware that I had a chip in my tooth until this very moment.
Is that true?
So, new insecurity unlocked. Thanks
See?
So much.
So, this next song.
Wait for it.
This song that my lovely mother introduced me to. And it's by a band called. it's by a band called Brook Assault. This is season.
I've been dying to have Olivia on my show. Her new album is called Guts, and we're finding all these fans that have these really amazing gutsy stories, and we want to surprise them with her. They're going to lose their mind. So here we go. Let's do it.
This is the studio we need.
You're going to be talking straight into the camera.
Hi, my name is Michaela Lee, and this is my gutsy story. Today I brought with me this key. It's the key to my first apartment that I moved into all by myself. I have a disability called cerebral palsy, which limits my mobility. Growing up, I wasn't sure if or when I would be able to live independently. And it makes me think about Olivia's song, Ballad of a Homeschooled Girl, because in that song, she talks about feeling insecure, anxious after growing up sheltered, and I definitely relate to that. She's helped me through so much with her music.
We wanted you to meet her.
You are amazing. You are so incredible.
I'm so happy to meet you.
Thanks for coming.
Oh my God.
You're incredible.
Oh, thank you so much.
That's a big deal, getting your own apartment
it's
in the first
huge.
Place. It's a terrifying thing. Oh,
yeah.
My gosh.
I'm excited about this. We wanted to surprise like people that felt like empowered. Like I felt empowered by listening to Gutsy. I'm 41 and I felt empowered. So
yes.
It's an incredible thing to connect with an artist like that.
But yes. I feel empowered listening to your story. I think that is so incredible and I admire you so much for that. That's not an easy feat. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you so much for coming. It was so nice to meet you.
And thank you for telling your story. It's so beautiful.
Don't worry about the cameras. This is very normal.
Hi, my name is Jasmine, and this is my gutsy item. It is a boarding pass. So I met a guy through work. We hit it off immediately, and he met my whole family. I met his whole family, and I was like, this is love. This is it. And so we were long distance for a minute, and I decided, I was like, I'm gonna spend my own money, and I'm gonna go out and visit him. So I go out to visit him, and the vibes were off. It was very weird. There's a girl there. She's driving us around. I'm very confused. So I go home. I'm like, I'm humiliated. So I'm out with my girls, and I run into the entire family. And they're like, oh, no. You know, he actually has a girlfriend. And I said, who? And they said it was the girl that was driving you around. And I said, oh, okay, good. So I was thinking about Olivia, I was thinking about her songs, and I said, I too want to meet his mom and tell him her son sucks. So that's exactly what I did. I would say thank you for really singing my inner teenager and really bringing her out and letting me.
Me too.
Oh my God.
That is the craziest story! Oh my gosh! I'm so sorry that happened to you!
It's okay. Oh it literally God. Doesn't even matter ever, ever again.
But you're a hell of a gutsy woman.
You
I
made
like
it through.
It.
Thank you.
You're gonna be out there with us. We don't want to have a surprise.
Oh my God!
We
thanks for coming!
It was so nice to meet you.
Oh my God, you're so amazing, you're so amazing. This is the best day ever. Oh God.
Thank you, Jasmine. That was amazing.
What the
Hi, my name is Cassie, and this is my gutsy story. I brought a receipt from the dining hall at my college, where me and my now husband, Chase, used to always get milkshakes together, and I really had feelings for him, but I thought, we can't date. I come from a religious Jewish background and family. They wouldn't approve. But I cannot let this person go who cares about me so much. Like, how can I let that go? And I eventually told my family, and that was probably the gutsiest thing I've ever done. It was the most scared I've ever been, I think. It all worked out. Eventually, they came around. They love him now. We just got married this September, 2 days after Guts was released. Her music means so much to me. I feel like so proud as like an older fan. She's such a great role model to so many people.
You're so sweet. That was so nice.
You're so generous.
And first of all, you are not an older fan. I am an older fan.
That was the most beautiful story. Thank you for sharing that.
I'm so honored to meet you right now, Olivia.
You're the coolest.
I'm so proud of you. You are doing such amazing things, and I love your music so much. So many girls out there, people of all genders and ages, are so lucky to have you in this industry to see what you do for them and your vulnerability and your passion. And I'm just like so honored
you
to tell you this.
Kind.
Oh my God, you are so eloquent. I've never that so when I meet people I love.
Congrats on your wedding.
Thank you so much.
Oh my God.
Congrats on your wedding.
Thank you.
Would you like a picture?
I would love a picture.
We have to take a picture
to
show him.
I'm gonna let her get one alone. That way you don't have to crop me.
Well, there you have it. Speardude 21 exposing rumors about Olivia Rodrigo being a bad person. It's so damn ridiculous that people keep spreading these false rumors about these celebrities just because they're not fans of them. It's like the haters of these celebrities and the media just keep attacking all these celebrities who are good people, which is a huge problem with the media and so many people who hate on these celebrities.